All right, guys, I'm not so hip anymore. I'm getting older, so I'm trying to figure out what's the difference between a lowrider and a slab. So I came out to the Houston Art Car Parade, and I got the answers from the experts. Explain to me the difference between a slab and a lowrider, because to me, I see a lot of similarities.
If you look at the artwork, this is more traditional. This is old school. The traditional is with the smaller rims, and you got the white walls. And with the slab, you got bigger rims. And then you got the inside looking very, very good.
Look at that bad boy.
Oh, yeah.
You can have some drinks in there, have a good old party, right?
That's the way you have it and stuff. It's more decorated with the old school.
So this is a lowrider, not a slab.
Not a slab.
A lowrider, they sit real, real low to the ground. A slab sits properly above the vogue tire. And they got hydraulics. They come with different custom paints. But on a slab, they don't trick the paint out like that. They're either gonna be one solid color or maybe two tops.
And a slab too, correct me if I'm wrong, is about the South. It's about Houston. It's about hip-hop culture, right?
Correct. Slab started in Houston, I'm gonna say, back in 83.
This is part of the slab culture, right?
Correct.
Explain that to me.
They started those wheels in 79. They originally came from the dealership with them, from Cadillac. That's not nothing that we just made up. We tried them on our lowriders. We loved the way it looked, and then they discontinued them. And then thanks to Texas Wire Well, remanufactured them and brought them out. Then he was able to extend the hub a little bit to give it a more unique look.